That changes things just a tad. Let's go here. Energy distribution manifold. I can leave that on there, and instead of putting on a turn rate, I could put that on, because that's actually gonna hook a brother up and give me better firepower if I combine that with what's going on. Yeah, boy. Yeah, that's a good little combination, being that that's a universal epic. Yeah. Tigers, you good?
And I'm just re-equipping some, reassigning some weapons to my
other guys.
Mm-hmm.
I hear you. Oh, since we got a guy here who plays Tigers, one of our viewers, Vlad, is actually a player. Vlad, I need to ask you a question, brother. And we're going to go over to here. How do you get available officer slots? Because I actually have. If I go... Darn, didn't want to do that. Go back there.
I've got like three officers waiting to be assigned.
Picked up, right. And I've got four stations. I've got an ensign engineering station that I have no one to put in. I need to be able to put somebody in there. How do I get extra officer slots so that I can fill that? They increase with level. Okay, well, I've went up one or two levels. So exactly what, I mean, is there a specific ratio that I need to be looking for, like every five levels or with every level?
Yeah, I'm at level 15 now myself.
Yeah, I think I'm at level 15 myself. Yeah, I'm at level 15. I'm at level 15. And I bought this one. You'll get more with, you will get more slots as you rank up. Okay, so basically it's going to be at a predetermined rank that they're going to give me, but it's just not going to be like I get a new slot after every rank. Thank you. Okay, he says it's going to be, you'll get one as you rank up, but it's not like every rank you get a new slot. So we may get one more
slot. After every so many times you rank up, you get a new slot.
Right, basically, that's what he's saying. All right, so that helps. But at level 15, I think what he's doing right now is I think he's trying to check to see, since we're at what our current level is, at what next level we may get an extra slot. I think that's what he's doing. Let's hold on, see what he got. You can buy some, but it's not necessary, to be honest. No, not a problem. We're not gonna buy. We'll grind it. It's not a big deal. We just want to know exactly when, because we both got three officers just chilling. I've got a Ferengi engineering officer, which is the one I wanted to put in that ensign engineering slot, and plus I've got my Klingon tactical and my Vulcan engineering officer. Oh, I got two engineers. Damn, I should have got that science officer and left that Ferengi's ass. Whatever. No biggie. I could probably turn that Vulcan into a training manual then. If I'm going to keep the Ferengi engineering officer, giving myself a diverse alien species. I got my Klingon tactical. I got a Saurian tactical. I got humans. I got Vulcan. I've got Bolian. Yeah. I'll take the Vulcan. I've already got Vulcan because that's Trill. Trill's a Vulcan. So I'm going to convert this girl here. Eject warp plasma? No. Fuse armor? No. Turret fabrication. Acetone beam. Boarding parties. Reroute power to shields. Now we're getting into the commons here. Chroniton bear, mind barrier. No. Boarding party.
Damn, I need some protocols.
This officer will be dismissed after creating the training manual. Yes, I'll do that. Training manual, engineering fuse armor 1. All female prions, or Orions, or Gorn only. You can dismiss them or turn them into training manuals. I go by aesthetics, to be honest. All female Orions or Gorn only. Good. Good rule of thumb. Well, we know what he does with his. Okay, so basically, I just used my Vulcan engineering officer, converted it to a manual, and she was dismissed. So I've got a new manual now. Okay. Run me a slave ship, man. He said he runs him a slave ship. He runs a slave ship. Well, you're a Klingon, so, I mean, there you have it. Now, my other question is, how do you use manuals? Okay, you get one slot at 30 and one slot at 50. Damn! Shit, dog. We got about 15 more levels before we get an officer slot. But like he said, it's not necessary to buy any. But, I mean, at least we'll have any one of them, if any of our people die, total 6 free ones. I don't understand what you mean by total 6 free ones. Total of 6 free slots? Oh, I get you. The four that we have plus the one we get at 30 and the one we get at 50 equals a total of 6. Now, is that how I'm understanding it? The three that we have, the fourth one that you see on my ship that's empty. And then 2 others. So in other words, am I looking for a free slot at level 20 as well? Because I only got 3. You can buy lifetime or individual slots from the Zen store, but yes, you got that right. Okay. Cool. That's what I wanted to make sure. All right, so that helps. Now to put on here, crew stations, is it crew stations? Okay, that was engineering too. I just want to make sure I got the right. Boarding party 1. I did fuse armor. So maybe I probably shouldn't have went for the higher level shit, huh? Maybe I fucked up again. Emergency power to shields. Okay, I'm not. Oh, it's ensign stuff. Okay. One slot for every 10 levels up to 50. Got you. That's how the slots work. Got you. Now, in order to teach the new skills, I need to promote the bridge officer to teach the new skills. Okay. Well, I mean, I did promote them. I mean, these guys, they've been promoted to... I've got them promoted up to lieutenants at the moment. I can't promote them any higher because... I'm not a high enough rank yet, so I've got to wait. But I haven't trained anybody in a new skill yet, either. Okay, I'm learning. See, Tigers?
I'm listening.
I know, I had to pause for a minute because I had to remember what I was getting ready to say to you. He's a really good... The skill I converted is ground and it's away team section. He's really good at showing... There's our training manual right there. Vlad is our training manual. Like, he showed me how to take those manuals that I got and where to go to, but now I've got to find the right section to be able to put it in. I see fuse armor 2. Not fuse armor, freeze armor. But yeah, he's showing me how to go about putting the training manuals to the guys. You have to promote them before you can do it. There it is. Unlock officer ability, fuse armor 1. Requirements is training manual, engineering, fuse armor 1. Cost to learn new ability. Available expertise. Promotion required. Ah, okay. Thank you.
Okay.
He said, don't tell my Klingon brethren I'm helping Starfleet. I promise your secret's safe with me, bro.
Now, what the hell did you just do?
Huh?
What did you just do?
I converted one of my officers, the new officers that I got that's waiting to be picked up, my Vulcan engineering officer. I converted her to a manual. So that I can use that manual to upgrade my engineering officer that I already have. Upgrade the ability. But those training manuals, you can use those training manuals to upgrade the abilities on your officers. Depending on what the manual is for. If it's for a space ability, then you have to do it through the ship and crew. I think you have to do it through stations on the ship. But if it's for your ground ability, you do it through the away team. You can actually go, like if you go to the away team and you'll see your four members of your away team. You can highlight their abilities that they have when they're on the ground. And when you press on it, you'll actually get a list of abilities that if you have the available experience, the training manual, and they're at the right promotion level, you can upgrade them with a new ability. You can train them for the new ability. This way they'll have a new ability at their disposal going to the ground or in their roles on the ship.